put out, because he's got Julio, and I'm going to make sure that we protect deep. Because right now we came in, Hurts, so... Oh, crap. Wait, was that for Hurts? It may have been a screen. Yeah, it was a screen. Okay, well, I know what to do now. If he's going to keep screening, then... Yeah, it's another screen, but... When you have this kind of defense, you can't really screen. Oh, wow, he's not screening. Oh, I thought I had that. Come on, give me a break. Okay, well, we know he's not making the best of reads, which is always nice to know, because when you make that read, oh, he's going to be one of those guys that just comes out in the same formation every single play. I got to watch, like, the flats. Ooh. I wish he caught it. I actually wish he caught it. Let's set this defensive unit. Would be the last yards or would have fumbled. Intimidating presence as a pass rusher, and that is or I could have possibly got you. You know that we talked to him. This guy's name is Vic Beasley Jr. on Xbox. Boy, he has been playing. You know, he could get arrested for that, I think. I'm actually not kidding. That's I think that's like, I don't know what it's technically called, but that's like, you can't just have a fake identity like that, unless I really am playing Vic Beasley Jr., which I doubt it. Okay. If we get another one of those, which I'm hoping for, if we get enough of them, it's game over. Oh, darn it. Okay. Now, it doesn't matter how short the videos are going to be, they're going to be strictly one game. So, if we get a quit, like, in the very beginning, again, strictly one game, I'm sorry, but that's just the way it's going to have to roll with, my schedule and stuff, so. Yeah. Made a nice play there. So if we can't stop him here, okay, he's coming out 5 wide. Okay, 5 wide never bothered me. I never usually have trouble with 5 wide. Tyler Lockett, Julio. Hopefully it's the 87. Maybe should have did a little bit. Come on, DJ Ward.
Gotta give the defense a lot of credit there, don't you, Jim? They are all.
You just call timeout.
All over the field. Nowhere to throw it, and it just results in a
did he?
They're in punting formation.
I don't know if he did, to be honest. If those guys are running streaks, to be honest. Okay, alright, okay. Mm-hmm. Oh crap, I wanted to fair catch that. Oh crap. I think I pressed Y a little too late. Started off with a nice inside zone. Guys, I just sniped the Ted Ginn, but we gotta get Ted Ginn some work in, so we're gonna actually streak him. First play of the game, because he's so fast, but sometimes that happens. We just gotta get him in open field. That's what we have to do. But I hope he'll be running the stick here. No, he's not. Okay. He is running the slant, which could be deadly in both ways. It could be deadly to us, and it could be deadly to him. Us, because if there's a linebacker there to stop him, consider himself pretty much screwed. But if there is a linebacker, Ted Ginn's known for fumbling and dropping balls, so that's not good. I'm going to actually let him pass the safety this time. Guys, don't worry. I'm going to let him pass the safety. Because he's totally going to pass the safety. Oh my gosh!
Well, Jim, it's almost impossible to guard these guys nowadays as they go down the field. These wide receivers,
Ted Ginn just lit him up.
Ballerinas, and even though you get tight coverage, they're so quick, they can get open and make the catches.
That is not okay. What?
The Eagles.
I mean, I'm live, so I can't look at that.
Point.
Look back at that, but guys.
The point after
what?
Is good.
Ted Ginn literally lit him up. Yo, that was a nice pickup. That was a nice pickup. As soon as I saw it, like, he catch it, I didn't think he caught it. I thought the cornerback, the safety, actually caught it. It was a pick, and I'm like, oh, great pick. And, well, I'm happy with how it turned out. That's all I'm going to say. Ooh, Ted Ginn legit lit him up. I mean, that was ugly. That was like, that was ugly too. That sack. Actually, that was with Beasley Jr. How do you feel? You sacked yourself. How do you feel? You draw it, throw on the offside. Wait, how do you feel?
Well, every defense is looking for
somebody. This guy's getting a sack. They're not even sending blitzes, like I swear.
Gets around the tackle and gets the sack. Third down after the sack. For this play, they'll go with two tight ends.
Could be potentially not five wide, but four.
Have to get to the 41 for a first.
All right, he just gave hope on, last hope on humanity, and he throws it out to Julio. Okay, I'm actually fine with that because when you think about it, mine was better. Mine was really better though. That was amazing, and Ted Ginn stayed on his feet. That was a monster play. Now, we kind of have to lock this guy up here because we're slacking off a little bit, celebrating a little too much from that play. We're taking some work time off, so we gotta get a ciabatta. Oh gosh, Taco Bell pump. You know what? It was... Alright. It was weird because it was a contain. Oh, his quarterback got hurt. Let's go. Who is it now? 14. Probably some terrible quarterback. Now this guy's probably like facepalming, like last thing I needed. Sucks to suck.
And that's a gain of 13. Good job that time.
And now it's first and goal, and I'm gonna send the in because I think it's a toss, and it's Ryan Fitzpatrick. Yo, why is it in that angle? I get actually legit nervous. What are you doing? You tripping, boy. Alright, he scored. Whatever. Alright. Okay.
This game is shaping up to be something special. Really, I like the feel of it. It's exciting. Can't wait to see what happens here in the rest of this quarter. Extra point is good.
All right. I'm actually going to put your clock on because it's getting kind of late. And I don't want the episodes to be too long for you guys. Because Madden games, they could get long. They really could. Especially when people don't kick the ball and wait like 5 minutes. Or wait an eternity and a half. Trust me, I mean, gets annoying. Really, really gets annoying. Sorry about this, guys. I'm sorry. It's just, those are the jerks in the world that, like, they don't ruin your day, but they're oh, wait, I meant to change the tempo. It wouldn't really matter. Or would it? Oh, someone got hurt, I think. Or he's just laying randomly on the ground. I don't know. Come on. You guys taking forever to pick this dang play. I'm just going to put your clock on. This is like trying to conserve clock as much as possible. Well, kind of, I guess.
Always good to have these
on two
clocks,
so but it sends a message. To be honest, buddy, I have all night. I mean, even though I'm streaming, the stream could be an hour long. I don't care. Second down and two to go. As long as I get the content out there, you know. And again, we don't do this for money, like at all.
Stop. Williams is a very smart runner. He knows situations in the game. He saw the first down yard markers, and what does he do? He gets past them and picks up the first down.
First down, offense readying for the snap.
Dude, you know, you'd think he'd know that all I'm doing is running. I know, but I mean, nope. Still completely clueless. I'm actually gonna go with a deep attack here. Maybe catch him sleeping. I don't know.
Second down coming up.
Maybe catch Ted Ginn awake, or maybe even get. Look at that!
Touchdown.
No, we got this guy sleeping. We got him sleeping. We got him sleeping. Maybe we should have waited a few more plays so we can waste in a little bit more clock, but we definitely got him sleeping, and it's fun to do that, trust me. It's really fun to catch people sleeping. And looks like he's going out for field goal. Field goal block, not say so and so. I actually may do some fakes. No.
Everyone's lined up for this kickoff.
Nice kick. Let's see. Oh, well, all right. He made the right decision.
Smith's gonna drop to a knee here, so this will come out to the 20. The Raiders.
Let him take forever.
The field after a touchdown.
He already has one penalty.
They had it, and they certainly attacked that secondary.
Hold on, guys. My dad might be coming up because that's all
you
know.
Well, Jim, let me ask you this: how do you like to be the defensive coordinator right now? Because you're over there, you don't know what's gonna happen. No matter
probably
what
coming
you
up
call,
soon.
You feel like, hey, the quarterback's hot.
Because like he watches TV before he goes to sleep downstairs, and then he comes up.
Fitzpatrick's lined up, two tight ends set.
I think he's coming up soon. Crap. Get the heck out of here.
And he's on the sidelines out of bounds.
He's just trying to run out of bounds. Like, alright, you're losing.
And doing it right is what this offensive player did that time. Had a chance to get out of bounds.
Nagging ball in second half. So,
really good job,
be honest, do whatever you want, buddy. I don't give two craps. I really don't.
In on the tackle.
Quarterbacks love throwing the football on first down. Usually, it's the easiest defense to throw against. They do a nice job that time. They get some good yards.
Almost the first down. Let me see. Fake.
The Raiders.
Something. Ooh, bro, look at this thing. Trying to be all like fancy.
Well,
this halfback draw. Sorry, I just put my hand over the mic.
Out of bounds, you do it.
Loss of a couple that time.
Sorry about that.
Almost to the 40 at the 39 yard line. The Eagles defense now is going to go nickel. Third down and three. Going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down.
Got to give the defense credit here, Jim Nance. Good job on the option play. They just attacked the offense.
I don't know if you guys can hear me.
The quarterback kept the
current
football,
status just swallowed
run,
Mike. If you can't hear me, I think that's what happened
going
in my last, in my, one of my later videos, in one of my like latest videos. It was a Siri draft challenge, and the sound just got distorted after a while. And I think that's because I swallowed my mic. I mean, the guy was calling timeouts, but like, I want him to know
that. First down on the way.
So if he comes out with five wide now. Okay, good. I just want this guy to know that, like, buddy, you suck. You suck. Okay, you suck. Karma. I think that was karma. I think it is. Very funny, very funny. Very funny, God. But in all seriousness, none of the day, this guy's a loser because he's getting arrested for, you know, faking someone's name. I'm not kidding when I say that because I'm actually reporting him. Call me whatever you want, but I don't put up with that kind of crap. Like, if it had, like, Vic Beasley Jr., like, 5-5, like, that's how you know it's a fan. But this guy's actually trying to act like he's the real Vic Beasley Jr., and that gets me annoyed. People that are fake. Now, is it really him? No, it's not, because Vic Beasley Jr. is actually training real football, not Madden, okay? And, I mean, listen, guys, if there's one thing that we're going to do, one last play, what would it be? Whatever it would be, it would be a pass to Ted Ginn. So, here we go. I don't think he's expecting it unless he's listening to what I'm saying, which could be very possible, which is very possible. I wish one of my old linemen actually caught that and took that to the house, because that would be funny, in my opinion. He just takes it. Alright. So we don't got Ginn on anything special, but Gates bought flats. And out of bounds. Let's run a bunch drive. Hopefully that's Ginn. Yes, that's Ginn. Let's go. Alright, listen. And you gotta run. When I say that, I mean run. Yo. Nice throw down. Guys, you think one more play? I think so. And I think I know who I'm hitting. That was a big gainer. Now it's time to back it up. Radford's gonna listen, your boy's not hitting him. Oh, come on. Touchdown. That's a TD. Okay. All right. So, it comes to a certain point where, it's just at a certain point where you could legit just, it's a freebie. I mean, to be honest, it's a freebie. Touchdown to close it. Bradford's got his third touchdown. I mean, Ted Ginn, though. The Eagles for the extra point. We really showed up to play.
Extra point was good.
The first half. Crap, my dad's coming up. Larry Ridley, ready to take things hold over on. Back in the studios, and you're watching you guys NFL probably not going to hear me talk. So, that's why.
The Raiders setting up for the kickoff. With this kick, the second half is underway. Hilton's going to start his return.
Ted Ginn, I mean, not Ted Ginn. TY. Ted Ginn would be better. We're just going to run. Waste the clock. Now they have good starting field position.
The Raiders come out in a dime package. First down at the 46.
Yo. D'Angelo Williams is not going to put up for that crap. A lot of teams in this league don't right. even do it anymore. This team, they can listen, but I'm putting on Drew Glock because, honestly, you're wasting my time, so Drew Glock is when. Williams left side. He'll pick up seven this time. I mean, as long as D'Angelo gets easy first, I mean, the game's practically over. It really is. At this point, it is over, and I would just end the stream. But, I mean, you guys might not think I won. I gotta prove it to you. This is going up way down. So,
toss play here to Williams. Bush is there to take him down.
How many yards? All right, listen, I would hit him with something deep. Like, trust me, I want to hit him with something deep. But it wouldn't be like, I'm kind of having mercy on this guy right now. I'm not. be in a complete jerk. Because I know people that do that. But, yeah, if we had any faster running back, legit, he may have actually got that. Alright, see, this is what he won't be expecting. The joke's on him right now, because this is the last thing he's expecting. It's like legit the last thing he is expecting, and he still gets me. Okay. So, that's the end of the chew clock era. Actually, I should have taken my points, because now it's just one possession game. That was actually my fault. That was a big mistake by me. I wasn't even paying attention. I thought we were up like two TDs or something. So the game, still not over. Although it seems like I'm in good position to win right now, it's not over. It really isn't. And I mean, what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna go in the best option for what he's doing right now, and that's just to play some tight man coverage because see, this guy's so predictable. He's so predictable. It's pass deep, then like it's like pass short run, pass short run, then pass deep in the mix. It's really like it's not even like guys, dude, stop, please, stop. You don't know. Like, keep calling audibles. I don't even care. Come on, that's why isn't my corner picking that, or whoever's out there? He should be picking that. That's an easy, like, interception. I don't understand. And I mean,
when you get down in the red zone, the offensive coordinator's got to call a play that deceives the defense. Let's see if he can do it. His team is down. He needs a big play here.
First down at the 20.
Ha! Huh. He dropped it. He deserved that, to be honest. He deserved to drop that. Just by the way, he's like faking Vic Beasley. He's faking that he's Vic Beasley. And he knows it. I mean, he knows it, and so do I. Like, he's not Vic Beasley. Because Vic Beasley would be training. It's a short pass. It's a little short pass right under here. Oh, come on. Come on. That should be a pick six. You're kidding. That should be a pick six. That really should be. I mean, just saying. Now, you guys couldn't hate on me for just using the D lineman. But it's a good way to get pressure. Okay, alright. So, what is he doing? He's beating us with Julio all the time. So we gotta have a safety. You know, keep dance. He's going for two. He's going for two. Okay. Oh wow, he's actually taking it. Okay. Now, the game's in my hands right now. All I have to do is burn him with Tepkin. There's no more wasting clock right now. We're at a point where if we can't even try to waste clock, because then it'll get ugly. It could possibly get ugly. And yada yada yada. So we're not wasting clock. We're just Ted Ginn all day. Because honestly, Ted Ginn is the way to go when it comes to this. I mean, think about it. Like, he's wide open every single time. Like, wide open. Alright, that was a rookie mistake. That was a bad... See, that was... Wanna know why that was such a bad mistake? Because now... He's gonna chew clock. He's gonna get into it. See, this is bad. And my dad's coming up. So we just practically lost. And you'll see what I mean by that in a second. But my dad's coming up, so I'm gonna turn off.
First down at the 46. Has Nelson gains 11.
That's all he's going to do. See, I don't think his kicker can make that far of a field goal, though. We should be good for now. Sorry if I don't talk in a little bit. Yeah, guys, I'm not going to talk for about 5 minutes. Starting now.
Now, first and 10. Murray's got it on the handoff. Brought down at the 38. He's averaging 5 yards per carry on the day. The football is at the 38. Not much time left here, and the defense will need to come up with a stop to maintain the tie. The reception by Nelson. That's a pickup of 14. The Raiders continue to pass the football. When they have, they've looked in one familiar direction. Nelson's been the top target, and he's been very strong in this game.
The offense, what a tremendous design they've had here today. They've had many ways to get this football to the wide receiver, and he has done a good job of taking advantage.
Oh, a big forced fumble would have been huge there. But nope. We just continue to suck. So, let's hope he knows that we're going to keep coming out in cover three sky, because that's what we're going to be doing. Please hike it. What a wussy not hiking it before the 2 minute warning. What a wussy. Because now he thinks he has the ball in his, he thinks he has the game in his hands. He does. Because of Sam Bradford's A throw. It's terrible, by the way. I hate Sam Bradford now. Carson Wentz all the way, man, you know. But, legit. Get down to the ground. We're going to call a timeout there, because now it's 7:21. And who's the joke on? It's on him right now. Because he's trying to cheese me out with all these cheesy plays, and now it's time to get some pressure, sack him, get him out of field goal range, and then basically screw him over. Because I don't know what that was. That should have been a pick. That's all I know. And now he's just doing 360 no-scopes. All over the place. And I don't even know if he can make this. Yeah, and if he can, good for him.
Every time an offense
I don't know if he can.
Pass, their chances of getting a score on that drive go up big time. So getting off the field is great.
Guys, the game is clearly almost won. Almost won by us. We just need to get in field goal range. And then we won. We won. Consider a victory.
Consider a victory. And show a jumbo look. First down at the 42. Travis Kelce comes down with it.
Really push, really push. So all we have to do is get into a field goal range.
So right into the hurry-up offense they go into this two-minute situation.
Yeah, these guys, all these pros, they've been doing this stuff since they were in high school running the two-minute offense, so I know they're ready for it.
Yeah, guys, I'm working on the clock. He's running on normal right now.
With two timeouts remaining, the Raiders will come out in the dive.
Oh gosh, this could be risky, but
all bunched up here as they get set at the line. The tackle's made.
Hey, good job. I thought I'd never say this, but good job, Sam Bradford. I guess you did okay. Was he just dancing? That was ugly.
We got about a minute to go here, and the game is tied. D'Angelo Williams. Williams brought down after picking up only a yard. The Raiders in a tie game will call a timeout. They clearly want the ball back with a chance to do something.
He screwed up. He really did.
The Eagles come to the line of scrimmage with two timeouts to play with.
Kelce's
a tight end, but now shifted into the backfield. The Eagles take it from the 33. He's got some daylight. Williams is
now we're definitely in field goal. Is he quitting? Oh, don't quit and be a wussy. Don't you quit and be a wussy. Oh. Let's go. So, guys. We got the first win of the season. Just to prove to you that we won. I will show you the board. Hold on. Thank you guys for watching.